Howdy guys and gals, welcome back to the Social Regressive. Today we're going to be testing 6mm arc a whole bunch. This is going to be a couple of different videos, so make sure that you like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to see when new ones come out. To start with today, I'm just going to be doing 100 yard accuracy testing, and I will be running all this over a chronograph so we can see how fast these bullets are moving out. I'm really curious to see how precise the velocities are, because of course that's going to help us to make better hits at long range. We are shooting the CMMG Endeavor 300 in 6mm arc, as you can see right here. This is just a fabulous rifle, really well built, has all the right parts in all the right places, and this really does help me to stay very stable. It's just a very accurate platform overall. Up front, I have a UTG Recon Flex bipod, which despite its $45 price tag, is actually an incredible little thing. This has one of the widest tracks that you're gonna find in a bipod out there. It makes it extremely stable for long range shooting. Not so great for flexible close range shooting where you have to maybe move around really quickly, but it does work really well if you wanna make very precise hits at long range. Really cool thing. Up here, we have the US Optics TS-20X. This is a 2.5-20 power scope. I'll put a link to the video review down below if you wanna check this out. But what we're gonna be testing is Hornady's ELDM. This is the 108 grain bullet in their match load. And then we're gonna be testing their 105 grain BTHP, which I love shooting in 243 Winchester. This is the Hornady black load. So far in the little bit of testing that I've done, this rifle does seem to prefer the black. It just seems to hit the accuracy note a little bit better, but we're gonna find out for sure. That was just some kind of willy-nilly shooting at targets at about 400 yards. But here at 100, we're gonna see exactly how tightly we can group this. First, the ELDM. Velocity, 2652. So as expected, this is moving out more slowly through this 20-inch barrel than it is through the 24-inch test barrel. Looking good so far, sub MOA. That group I can see out there has definitely kind of spread out. And this could be as the barrel is heating, so maybe we'll shoot another 5-shot group just to see if they cluster up a little bit better. But let's take a look at our velocities so far. We have an average of 2,640 feet per second, extreme spread of 31, so that's not bad at all. Okay. Here we go. Standard deviation of velocity, 12.6. That is not bad at all for factory ammunition. All right, so we got 2621, 2633, 2645, 2648, and 2652. So yes, it looks like the heat from the barrel is starting to make these move a little faster. So I will shoot another 5-shot group. It's pretty obvious that the velocities are climbing since I'm not really giving it a chance to cool down between shots. Let's go ahead and shoot the BTHP match load since it is already loaded up in there and probably about the same heat. We'll do that and then we'll come back and do the ELDM. 2640. All right, those are kind of stringing out as well. Let's take a look. It still looks like it's about one MOA. We'll take a look here in a second. All right, our average speed, 2658. Extreme spread of only 23.8 feet per second. Standard deviation of velocity of 10 feet per second. This is one heck of a load. Okay, that's cool. 2664. 2662, 2662, 2663, 2640. Okay, so I think we have kind of hit a kind of a plateau in the heat in the barrel here. We're seeing pretty, just very consistent velocities in here. Now, of course, if we were shooting a little bit more slowly, we could probably get a little bit more consistency. But so far, I think this is probably a pretty good indication of what this can do. Now let's quick switch over to the ELDM. While the barrel is still nice and hot. All right, those have grouped up better. Let's see what else we're working with. The average is 2643 feet per second. Extreme spread of 32.8, so that's pretty much what we're looking at before. I think it was 31 something. Standard deviation of velocity, 14.1. So we are maintaining a good standard deviation of velocity. It really seems to be maintaining what we had before. Let's see the individual numbers. 2658, 2643, 2656, 2634, 2625. It seems like our heat is pretty stable inside the barrel now, so I'm not too concerned about how much it's heating up the rounds differently. I think they're all shooting about the same now. Group number one, the 108 grain ELDM, is coming in pretty much exactly at 2 inches right here, at 100 yards. The horizontal, as you can see, is very good. It's the vertical that's a little off. Now on this one, some of that will be the barrel heating up. It looked like as the barrel heated, then the hits actually started working their way down, which is kind of interesting. I've had some rifles that do this, but yeah, it's good horizontally. Like you can see, there's pretty much no wind out here today. I think that most of this dispersion is going to be coming from the barrel harmonics, not so much from the velocity. I think the velocity is going to have a small impact here. Moving up, we are getting tighter groups like I was kind of seeing out in practical shooting. This one is coming in. It's under 2 inches right here. This is probably about somewhere between 1.5 to 1.75. So yeah, not extremely tight, but you can see that the horizontal is quite good, and I suspect that this will be good at long range here today. Down here we have the final ELDM group, and this is still coming in at about 2 inches. This is actually just a little bit over 2 inches, but you can see that four of the shots are clustering together pretty tightly here, and that we have just one flyer instead of things kind of stringing down all the way. So let's see what this can do at 600 yards. As we get ready for our 600 yard test on this humanoid silhouette target, I do need to point a couple things out. First, this ammunition is probably designed for a 24-inch barrel. That's how the test barrels usually go. And so if you have a bolt action with a 24-inch barrel, you'll probably get a little bit better accuracy. It's just going to be set up for you properly. But another thing is that sometimes with these big bullets, they do settle down better at longer ranges. So we're going to see if that's the case. You probably noticed in that last clip that I didn't do this. Thankfully, it all piles up really neatly in one spot. It was really easy to find. I only lost one. That's still a loss, but could be worse. I pulled that one.
Yeah, low.
All right, I see those hits. Those are decent. I've been using the Longshot LR3 today. This is the Wi-Fi repeater. Way down there is the actual camera. Both of them are Wi-Fi routers, but this one's the actual repeater that I can use up close. And yeah, this allows me to see my target really up close so I can see actually where I'm hitting. And actually, I can see all those little bullet holes. It's a very high resolution system, and you can actually crank up the frame rate too, so you can see splashes of dirt. This is really making this possible today. 600 yards with Hornady Black. This is only a difference of 0.2 milliradians. That's a pretty slick bullet. Thank you. Looking good. It seems like the two of them shoot pretty much identically. So actually, based on the impact that we've seen before at 100 yards, as long as you just dial that little bit of extra here on the turret, you're gonna get the exact same point of impact. It looks like we have the same windage, the same spread. So you can interchange these bullets, and that is a really cool thing. A lot of times when I have two different loads, two different bullets, then they're gonna have pretty radically different impacts, and I have to keep that in mind, write it down on a piece of paper somewhere. But this one, I can just swap them out and they are good to go. Pretty cool. To get a sense of scale on these hits, I brought the target indoors, and as you can see, it's a real mess. We had what we call around here a gully washer. It was coming down real hard, and this was actually just kind of a soupy mess that I rolled up as best I could and hoped would dry out. So yeah, we do have some tears in the paper, but looking pretty good overall. We can still see where we hit. There was one other thing that was caught in the rain, though, and that was this, my long-range camera. And in the kind of rain that you're seeing in this footage, you can imagine what happened to it. Absolutely nothing. If you are looking for a long-range target camera that can show you your hits and some of your misses, and you want to make sure that if you do get a really nasty sudden pop-up thunderstorm that it's actually going to survive, this is the one. This sucker can take just about anything. It just kept on pumping out its signal the whole time. Once the thunderstorm was over, I went and collected it. This thing rocks. All right, well, let's take a look at the target here. These four shots in the shoulder area all can easily fit just in the palm of my hand. In general, our hits are just a tad over a full hand wide. So we have these two right here that came in right next to each other. This one's a 105 and this one is a 108 right down here. And then this is a mix of 105s and 108s. And then all that's kind of coming in about one hand high, including this guy right here. But then once we got into the 105s, they started to drop a bit with some of these. So we actually have a pretty good span, almost another hand going on here. So we're roughly two hands high and about a hand, you know, a total spread of a hand wide. So it looks like the bullets did start to settle down as they got into the longer distances. If you want to see how this adds up to practical shooting against steel, make sure you check out the next video. We're going to be knocking down steel from 200 to 500 meters, and we had very little difficulty getting on target with that. Thank you to CMMG Hornady and US Optics for sending the equipment for us to play with. And thank you to patrons of the Destructive Arts that have purchased items like this one right here. This is how I'm getting better audio. This is the Tascam DR70D. This is a solid state recorder that can take four XLR inputs. And I've been using this right here. This is a Rode NTG 4 Plus. I'm a real snob about microphones, and I just love that the sound that we get through this. And this is the sort of stuff that our patrons of the Destructive Arts have been purchasing in order to get better video and audio quality overall. And this one's a really big deal. I've talked about this in a previous video, but check this guy out right here. This is one that I've wanted to add to the collection for a while. This is the Rode Blimp. It actually has what's called a dead wombat that fits over the top of this, and it helps to eliminate a lot of that wind sound. On this shoot, this would have sounded truly terrible if we hadn't had that dead cat or dead wombat attached. It just soaks up all the wind noise and doesn't let the wind actually directly strike the microphone, getting a lot of that kind of booming sound that you get when you're outdoors. So yeah, we go out in windy environments all the time, and this is really going to help us out a whole lot. So thank you, patrons of the Destructive Arts. We have Sportsman's Guide and Stan and Mary at the 338 Lapua Magnum level. And then we have Howard, Peter, Joseph Davis, and Mr. No Name at the 300 Win Mag level, and a bunch of other guys chipping in a buck or two a month to help keep these videos coming. If you want to be one of those, I'll put a link to Patreon. I'll see you guys around. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.